started with this exam. We identified the members, we identified the joints, then we have two unknown displacements, D1 and D2, and we have Q1 equals 0, Q capital, Q2 equals minus 2, then we have Q7, we have Q8, we have Q3, we have Q4, and Q5 and Q6. So we have Q, which is 8 by 1, equal the big stiffness matrix, for the structure, which is 8 by 8, right, times these. We have D1 and D2, and the rest are zeros. There is D1 and D2. We should calculate, or we should find. The rest are zeros. D7, D8, 0. D5, D6, 0. D3, D4, 0.
I have
to do that. Let me. Okay? Then, whenever you have 0 displacement, it means there is a reaction there. It means there is a Q there. Good? So we have this here, we have 0, we have minus 2, then we have Q3, Q4, Q5, Q6, Q7, Q8, and we fill this matrix. We assembled this matrix in the previous lecture. So now what we need to do is to calculate D1 and D2. Two equations, two unknowns. 0 equal this row with this. So the first term times D1 plus the second term times D2, that's equal to 0. So one equation with two unknowns. Then minus 2 equal the second row times this. So two equations, two unknowns, you should be able to find D1 and D2. Good? You find D1 and D2. Once you find D1 and D2, you can calculate all the other reactions. Now Q3 equal what? Third row times this. Now you have those. Then you calculate Q3, Q4, Q5, Q6, Q7, and Q8. Okay? Now we calculated the nodal displacement for the structure in the global direction, in the XY direction, and we calculated the reactions. This is enough for the analysis of thrust. This is enough for the analysis of thrust. You have the reactions, you have the displacement everywhere. Now, from you can come to any joint now, to this joint, you have the two reactions. And you can calculate the force and displacement from statics. You go back to statics. And you can come here and you can calculate the force and displacement and the force and displacement. Good? But if we want to use the matrix method to calculate the internal force in each member, how we go from Q capital now to Q small? So for each member, what we have? For each member, we have and the near and far ends, right? Then we have Q small and Q F, right? Remember, we had Q equal what? We transform Q from the local coordinate to the global coordinate. We transform this one to the we have this D equal transformation matrix times D. We transform this one into this, right? The global D. So we have D and DF. And this is the transformation matrix, which is, anybody remember this? What's this? That's the member stiffness matrix. The member stiffness matrix is EA over L 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. This is the transformation matrix equal
lambda
x, lambda y, zero, minus lambda 0, 0, zero. Then 0, 0, lambda x, lambda y. Good? So that's what we have. Now we have this one, we can calculate anything here. For each member now, For each member, we can calculate this, the nodal displacement. But if you want the force in this, in each member, the force in each member, what did we have? We had Q equal what?
K prime.
We have K prime D, which is T D. So this is D. Right? It's K prime D. This is that. Right? Now we have Q capital equal.
TTQ
small.
TT.
This is K capital for the member times D. Right? This is K capital for the member times D.
Turn Q capital to say we like T transpose the Q small.
T transpose
the Q small.
Q small. This is what we have. Q capital equal T transpose times Q. So Q capital equal what? For a member. What do we have? Q and X, Q and Y, Q F X, Q F Y, right? Four of them. Q and X, Q and Y, M. Q. Q F X, Q F Y. By the way, what's the direction here? From what is the sense of the numbers? Going this way?
The last part.
This way? And this one?
The shoulder.
This way? All of them. So this defines the near and far. So if you want to talk about member number one, we want to calculate Q in member number two, which is the near end is joint one, the far end is joint 3, right? And the nodal displacement at joint 1, we have 1 and 2, and here we have 5 and 6. Good? So we have this equal. What's the transpose of T?
Lambda X, lambda Y.
Equal what now? Times
Q and one Q.
It's in the direction of the member. It's in the direction of the member. Good? This is what's Q and for this member two, what's Q and
one?
In this direction. Q and is in this direction. What's Q F? Positive in this direction, right? Positive in the global x dash of the member. Now for this number, 3, Q, this is the near and this is the far. So Qn is in this direction. This is how we derive it. And Qf is here in the x dash direction for the member. Likewise for this one. This is the near, this is the far. So this is Qn and this is Qf. Now, Q. If you want to calculate Qf, Qf what's equal what? Yeah, look. Let's assemble this for number one, number two. For member number two. What do we have? What's linear? This is number two. Right? This is number two. So what's
Qf?
Qn x to say Qn.
Yeah, what's Qn x? Now we calculated all Qs. Could Q capital we calculated? What's Q here? Zero. There is no reaction, there is no force. No reaction, no force. So Q, is there any Q here?
No.
Nothing. So what's Q? An here. Minus 2. Likewise, what do we have here? Q5, Q6. We have the values. And when you calculate Q5, Q6, this is where you put them for this number. Equal. Lambda x for the member, we had it. We calculated these values. And we have lambda x and the y for each member. So we have them. And what's this one? He said this is Q.
Lambda x سالب واحد لambda y لambda y صفر.
This one zero.
لا سالب واحد.
This is minus one.
آه وال y صفر.
And this is zero. So this is minus one and this is zero according to that. So how we calculate Qn? Do you want to calculate Qn or Qf? What's Qf? So this is what we have. Zero equal this times four. Right? So zero equal minus Q2 n plus zero. It means Q2 equal
zero.
And minus two equal zero times this. So the force in the member in this member is zero. This member will not have any force. So what's the internal force in this member? Zero, according to our calculation. According to our calculation. For the second number, it's not a zero force. It's a zero force number from the loading. And accordingly, this is what we get. Zero. This is what we get. Zero. Now, if you have a force in this direction, it will not be zero. But it looks like everything is carried by the diagonals. Carried by the diagonals. If you remove this number, what will happen? Let's go back to the basics. How many anions we have? Six reactions, right? Two, four, six. Six reactions. How many members we have?
Three.
One, two, three. So this is nine anions from the equilibrium, from the forces. Nine anions. How many joints we have?
One.
One.
Two.
Two. Three. Four. How many equations we have? Eight. So this one is indeterminate to the first degree. Yeah, you can't let anybody solve this one. If you had a look at it now, what a force. You cannot get any force. But now, if I remove this number, if we remove this number, we keep the two member assembly. How many reactions we have? Four. How many members we have?
Two.
So a total of six and nine. How many joints we have? Three. How many equations we have?
Six.
So it's stable, 6 equals 6, and determinate. So in this case, this number is redundant. This number is redundant. Why redundant? For this loading only. What if you have loading in this direction? It will help. Or for the shape. Good. But this is static determinancy. Static determinancy. We said there is kinematic determinancy. And this one indeterminate kinematically, to what degree? Kinematic, it means how many unknown displacements. How many we have? Only this and this. So this one is indeterminate to the second degree. The only unknowns you need to find is D1 and D2. D1 and D2. Good? So this is what you get. Then you calculate this and that. The thing that I want to tell you, and this one, by the way, you can write it the other way by having the inverse, and Q equal inverse of T transpose is T, I think, times Q. Look, Qf, this is the only thing I'm giving this lecture. Why? There's Qn and Qf, you can calculate Qn and Qf. Good? Which one is key? Always, they will be the same. And Q will force, but remember, it's the same. So which one is easier to calculate? And each member has one or two. واحد على النير, واحد على الفار. Which one is the easier to calculate, the near or the far for the number? Near. Why the near? I say the far. Okay. Always calculate. Q1 and Qf, they will be the same. But always better to calculate Qf. Why? If you calculate Qn for a member equal 3. What does it mean? شو معنى؟ هيك بترص احنا يا مهند الفورس ايكوال 3 شو بنقول بين قوسين what do we say between two brackets and two compression or compression if you calculate qn for a number equal 3 is it tension or compression compression this is how we derived it this is how we derived it this is a qn and this is a qf Qn on the local is compression. See? It's in the member. It's in the positive x dash, but in the member. Qf is tension on the member. Fall on the number. Always calculate Qf. If it's positive, tension. If it's negative, compression. If you calculate Qn, that's fine. But if it's positive, compression. If it's negative, tension. Because we calculate all of this based on this derivation. However, if you get Q far, the far, oh, positive tension, negative compression. You have one question in the final exam. If this one takes more than 30 minutes to calculate D1, D2, D3, my Qs, and to calculate the force in each member using this one,